Hello friends, welcome back again for this exciting video series tutorial for Core Java Programming, and let us continue our discussion for collection interface. And let us review the programs. So collection ArrayList using normal data members. So I have declared a ArrayList collection and assigned it to, I have declared a collection interface ArrayList and I am assigning it to ArrayList class. ArrayList class object, and these are the different methods we can use. So add method, so since it is only a collection of strings, so I'm just adding some couple of strings here, and ArrayList and ArrayList temp. So we will see what is ArrayList temp. It is similar to ArrayList. Add all method. So what I'm doing is I have already added three members in the ArrayList, and now I want to demonstrate add all method. So using this array temp, I am going to add all the array temp members into ArrayList, and when we run this program we will see the output. So it will be like three members plus three members, so total six members. Remove method, so remove by object. With this object it will remove only one object. Remove all, so it will remove the objects which are present in this. So it will remove these three, the one which are associated with array temp. So it will just remove only these three. So remove all will remove whatever is given in here, and not all the data members, all the members. Contains method, so it is basically a search method. It will contain, it will show if it contains this particular object. Contains also, again I am remove all is removing only limited data members, only limited members. Contains all will search only limited data members. Clear method will delete all the data members, all the objects, and again I am putting add here. Is empty method, it will just check if the list is empty. Hash code method, it will return the hash code value of the object. Equals method will compare these two objects or two collection interfaces. To array method, so ArrayList to array, so I am converting it into string array because it is a collection of string, and then using for loop I am just printing the values. Iterator method, so iterator method, we can iterate through the objects of collection and we can see their values and their objects. Remove, so remove method, so remove, earlier we saw remove by object, now this is remove by index. So I want to remove the zeroth element of the ArrayList. Retain all, retain all will only retain these members, will delete all the members except these. So it is actually retaining only these members. Now let us run this program, the no compilation error, and we will see the output. So ArrayList, so we'll see this ArrayList how the members are getting added. It is now, it is adding, it is deleting these three here, and contains false, contains all is empty, hash code equal to array. So this is in the for loop we printed, and this is using iterator method. Now let us understand another example. So ArrayList using custom object type. So in this earlier example, the ArrayList what we had is only of type string. Now instead of that, we will be seeing a custom object type. So I am again building an ArrayList, but instead of string, I am making it as a class object. So it will be of this class type. That is the beauty. That is the beauty of collection. So we can build, we can have collection of not only primitive type but object types also. So I have created an ArrayList of HR employee type, and I am just adding the data members, or in short the objects. The three objects I have added, and I am checking the size here. Then again ArrayList temp, and all add all method, remove method. So when I want to remove, I need to specify all the parameters so that it will search for all matching values and it will remove particular that. So remove by object. And remember, need to typecast to an object. this typecasting has to be there. Array remove, remove all. Again, it will just remove the list of arguments, list of objects which are present here from this list. Contents method, so it will just it will just search for one particular object matching with all these values for this class. Contains all method, it is a multiple search. Clear method will delete all the members. Is empty, as the name itself says, it is, it will show it is empty or not. Hash code will give hash code values, and equals method. So in this equals method, I am just comparing these two array lists of type HR employee. Two array method. So as we see, as we saw in earlier example, two array. I am converting it into HR employee object array, and then I am just printing ID, name, and salary. And the same thing I will be doing it using iterator method. So let us see the output. So these are a couple of values what we intend to have at the start, and then contents all is empty, hash code equals two array using two array and iterator method. In the next example, we will be seeing priority queue using normal data. So priority queue, I have a collection of priority queue of type string. So I'm adding those here, and as usual, I am checking all, add all, remove all, contains, add all, contains all, clear, is empty, hash code method, equals method. So this is equals and two array and iterator. Here we can also see remove by index and retain all method. Let us see if it runs and see the output. Excellent. So all this the source code is shared in my GitHub repository, and I will share you the link in the comment section. Last example is hash set using normal data member. So I have I want to have a collection of string of type hash set. So this is the way to declare, and as usual, I'm checking all the methods applicable for hash set. Let us run this and see if what is the output. Excellent. So everything is working. Now let us come back to the interview questions. So difference between collection and collections. So collections, understanding of collections, we will see in next video series. And just for now, just try to understand the difference. So collection is an interface. Collections is a class. Collection used to represent group of individual objects as single entity, and collections a utility class which defines many utility methods, for example sorting and searching. This is a root interface of collection hierarchy. It is not a root element. Declares an abstract method, all abstract methods. Defines all static methods. Difference between clear and remove all method in collection. Clear will delete all the members. Remove will delete given single member. Remove all will delete given multiple members. May not delete all the members. Difference between list, set, and map. In the subsequent video, we will see in detail what is list, set, and map. But for now, just try to understand list. So in terms of indexed or ordered, list is yes and all others are no. Duplicate elements are allowed in the list, yes. No, and no duplicate key is allowed. Values can be duplicate. Null elements is possible in list. Only one is possible, and only one key can be null, and only one value can be null in map. Insertion order in the list, yes, it can be accessed using index, and all other places is no. We have to iterate. Data structure, so list is having array data structure type, set is having underlying map implementation and hashing technique. Difference between, okay, let's continue. this difference between list, set and queue. So there are certain parameters and you can see this in the chart. So that's all for this video, guys. For all upcoming next video, exciting video series, please like, comment and share my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.